Lines from the Lay of the Last Minstrel, written by Sir Walter Scott. This is a very small poem, and I'm gonna just summarize that for you because this poem is small but it carries a very vast message. So let me read that first for you. Breathes there the man with soul dead, who never to himself hath said, "This is my own, my native land," whose heart hath ne'er within him burned, as home his footstep he had turned. So basically, Sir Walter Scott asks in this poem that is there any man who lives and who does not think of his motherland when he goes abroad? And he continues that if there is such person whose heart does not dance with joy at thought of returning his home / country, right, after traveling in foreign land, then he is then criminally unpatriotic. So what he means is that if a person does not thinks about his homeland when he goes abroad, he's basically unpatriotic. And then this is what he had told in the first para. If such dear breath go mark him well, for him no minstrel raptors swell, high though his titles, proud his name, boundless his wealth as wish can claim. So he tells in the second is this, that mark him well. So what does this mean? It means that if you know a person who is unpatriotic, stay away from him. He is very selfish and he could be dangerous, and he is a hypocrite, selfish, and no minstrel would sing him for him. What's a minstrel? If you look down, we have the meaning of minstrel over here. Minstrel means a man who sang and recited either as a wandering entertainer or as a regular member of the nobleman's household. So, and let's continue. What else did the poet told? He told that these people are worthless and selfish. They spend their whole wealth on themselves and they do not help the poor, right? And they do not even spend their money on their country. And they lose all their fame, respect and honor. And as a punishment for this, for their disloyalty to their motherland, people reject such people and brand them as traitor, right? So let's continue from here. Despite those titles, power and pelf, the wretch concentrated all in self, living shall forfeit fair renown, and double dying shall go down to the wild dust from whence he sprung, unwept, unhonored and unsung. So in this last paragraph, we have heard the word double dying. So what does double dying mean? Double dying means his first death is in the form of his rejection by the people. He is boycotted and hated by the people even though alive, and he is treated like a dead person. And right, so this is his first death. And his second death is when he is being buried in the same ordinary dust from where he had sprung. Sprung means born, from where he had been born. On his death, no one feels sorry, nobody weeps on his death, no one honors him. Even the minstrels do not sing at his death. No poet will compose beautiful lyrics in his praise, and no historian will remember him. Such people die in disgrace and dishonor. Such is the faith of all unpatriotic people. So our poem has ended. Thank you very much.